Hello everyone. In this presentation, we will discuss about the scope of aquaculture. As we all know that the freshwater aquaculture system in the country has primarily confined to three Indian major carps, that is Rohu, Katla and Mrigala, with exotic species, silver carp, grass carp and common carp, which form the second important group. Among the catfishes, Magur, we called it as Clarius petrachus, has been the single species that has received certain level of attention both from the researchers and from farmers due to its high consumer preference, high market value and most importantly, its suitability for farming in shallow and derelict water bodies with adverse ecological conditions. In the recent years, we have seen increasing interest of farming for pangasius species, especially in Kolleru Lake region of Andhra Pradesh, due to its high growth potential and ready market. Apart from these fish species, certain potential species like Labio calvarsu, Labio gonius, Labio bata, Labio dusumeri, Labio fimbriatus, Barbados carneticus, Pontius pulchellus, Pontius colus, Pontius serrana and Sirena cirrhosa have also gained attention, and these species have also been started cultivation by the aquaculturists. Some of these species, they are being cultured at a very low level in different parts of the country, mostly based on the wild seed collection. As far as these species are concerned, there are no set hatcheries for their seeds and they are not well propagated. The freshwater air breathing fishes, we call them as catfishes, and the non-air breathing fishes like Channa marulius, Channa striatus, Channa punctatus, Channa gachua, Channa stewartii, they have not been taken up for the aquaculture activities in serious way. They have been left apart. With the technological advancements and the availability of technology for seed production, the culture of air-breathing fishes like Clarius petrachus, Heteropneustis fossilis, commonly called as Magur and Singi, and the non-air-breathing fishes like Volago atu, Mr. Singhala, Mr. Seor, Hora vulgaris, Brachystoma, Pangasius pangasius, and other scientifically organized catfishes farming can be taken up in extensive and semi-intensive way. Apart from the fishes, if we talk about the non-fish organisms, the giant freshwater prawn, commonly called as Macrobrachium rosenbergi, has been the principal species adopted, which is both under the monoculture and under mixed farming of freshwater prawn production for about 43 tons in the country at present. However, Macrobrachium malcosomai and Macrobrachium yangeticum have not been taken up in a big way still. If we talk about the brackish water sector, the aquaculture development is mostly contributed by shrimp, which is commonly called as the shrimp, and the scientific name is Benius monodon. The other shrimp species like Phenorpenius indicus, Phenorpenius marguis, Penius pencillatus, Marsupenius japonicus, and Penius semisulcatus are not yet cultured on a commercial level and on a large scale culture. Recently, it has been found that Phenorpenius Venami culture is developing in India. The finfish species like the sea basses, Metis carifer and groupers, Ephinephilus, grey mullet, Mugilcephalus, pearl spot, Etroplus, Suratensis, milkfish, Chenos, these are the promising fishes and they are considered ideal for aquaculture which has not yet been exploited. Coming to the potential marine finfishes, we have different species such as Ephinelpis, Ephenelphus malbaricus, Ephenelphus coicoides, Ephenelphus taurina, Ephenelphus phosphogutatus, Ephenelphus polyphacadion, Chromoleptis altavilis, Rhecicentrin canadum, Seriola quadricodiata, Trachinostis blotchii, Coryphena hippurus, Cetos erumei, Lutjanus argenti maculatus, and Pampus argenti. Mariculture is expected to be a major activity in the Indian coastal areas in the years to come. Given the wide spectrum of cultivable species and technologies available, the long coastline of the Indian subcontinent and the favorable climate conditions, we expect that mariculture is likely to generate considerable interest among the coastal population and entrepreneurs. If we talk about the present era of food insecurity, aquaculture is showing enormous potential to feed not only the ever-increasing human population, but also the aquaculture products, which can be utilized as a feed ingredient in the diets of different domesticated animals of high commercial value. The aquaculture sector has become a modern, dynamic industry, which is producing safe, high-valuable, and high-quality products, and it has developed the means of environmentally sustainable. We all know that sustainable aquaculture is currently the need in India as elsewhere. Eco-friendly aquaculture in harmony with environmental and socio-economic needs of the society has yet to be evolved. Thank you all.